A keyhole garden is basically a circular raised garden bed with a built-in walkway and a central basket for watering and adding compost.
We at Catholic Relief Services believe that it's an excellent way for a family to grow a variety of vegetables throughout the year, especially during dry and cold months.
It's called a keyhole because the walkway and the basket at the center of the garden makes it look like a keyhole when seen from above.
The shape and height of the garden makes it easy for people to tend the garden around them, while the basket at the center helps feed and water the garden.
Making a keyhole garden is fairly simple with a little help from family, friends, and neighbors. You can build one in just a few hours. You'll need to find the space, about 2 meters, and it's best near the kitchen.
The beauty of a keyhole garden is that there's room for improvisation. Using materials available to you, it can cost very little to make your own.
All you need are rocks and stones to build the wall, spades, thatching grass for the central basket, agave aloe leaves or tree branches, cardboard, tin cans to cover the surface, manure for nutrients, about 10 to 20 wheelbarrows, wood ash, about 2 wheelbarrows, string or rope, about 10 meters, sticks to build a frame for the inner basket, straw or grass for mulching or compost, and of course, soil, lots of it, about 10 to 20 wheelbarrows. Once you have all the materials, you're ready to build your keyhole garden. Mark the center of your garden. Using the string and 2 sticks, draw a circle with about a 2 meter diameter. Or place the spade on the ground and draw a circle. Place the rocks on the outline of the circle, also tracing a walkway or the keyhole.
The walkway is the entrance or key to your garden. Ideally, it should face your kitchen or home and be big enough for you to stand in comfortably.
Build a simple basket about 2 hand lengths in diameter and 1 spade length in height, or 1 meter high.
Or you can use an old bottomless bucket like this, set it in the center, and fill it with stones.
Place the basket at the center of the circle. This basket will house the compost and straw that will filter the recycled water from washing dishes or laundry.
Now it's time to build the garden bed. You can use cardboard, tree branches, tin cans, or even aloe. Spread it in a base layer on the inside of the garden.
This base creates a kind of sponge that helps keep moisture in the garden. It also breaks down over time and continues to feed the soil. Now, add a layer of soil, enough to cover the base.
After a layer of soil, then you add a layer of manure.
Add another layer of soil. Add a thin layer of ash. Then add another layer of soil.
As you add layers and begin to fill in the garden, make sure you start to move up your bucket as well.
Gradually build up the wall as you add the layers.
So after you add the layers of aloe, soil, manure, soil, and ash, now it's time to create your top layer. It's best to slope the surface like a roof of a house to keep the keyhole garden from sinking towards the center. Now that all the layers have been added and the garden is almost complete, it's time to remove the bucket from the center basket.
The different layers of aloe, cardboard, cans, soil, ash, manure, and more soil help make the garden rich in nutrients and retains moisture. It's a healthy environment for plants to grow.
Now you're ready to plant. Catholic Relief Services recommends companion planting, meaning that you choose plants that complement each other well based on space, nutrient and water needs, as well as pest management. We also recommend planting at least 4 different types of vegetables in order to ensure a well-balanced diet.
Place the leafy crops next to the root crops. Plant the seeds about a thumb length apart in a circular or curved rows to keep the topsoil from running off when watering the garden. Put a thin layer of mulch on the surface to protect the seeds. Add water to the surface and you're done. You can save water by pouring recycled water used for washing dishes, clothes, and bathing into the central basket. The straw and other materials in the basket will help filter the water. You can also water with clean water on the surface. Toss kitchen scraps and manure into the center basket. You can supplement the stone basket keyhole garden with manure tea. You can brew manure tea by placing a porous sack of manure in a bucket of water. Add manure and topsoil to the top layer after about 3 growing seasons. Remember, the more you feed and take care of your garden, the more it will feed you. In a matter of weeks, you'll be able to harvest your first crops just like Ernest Mpete.
Keyhole gardening is more productive than the traditional. It produces more vegetables and it is very easy to work on.
Mabaputi harvests enough crops to feed her family and supplement her income.
The money that I get from the keyhole garden pays school fees for my kids and also buying medicine.
Lehlo Honoholo's gardens were so productive, he built a farm stand to sell the vegetables he grows.
From these vegetables, I've made mini market there to sell for the community.
In a matter of weeks, you'll be able to harvest your first crops, just like the community of Malabanye in Lesotho. It's simple. Build a keyhole garden and you too can grow your own food.
Ah,